All right, hello everyone. This is Willie. So this is the first time I'm doing a commented Toho video. Well, this isn't Toho, but gameplay video on this channel. So this is Danmakai. This is a very Toho-like, but not Toho game, a bullet hell game. And this video, I'm going to be going through all of the challenge spells. If you go here, there's a challenge mode where you can play through basically every spell card in the game at zero power and try to capture them. So there's every spell in the game. There's also a few special spells at the end that don't appear in the main game. And I'll be going through each one, showing a capture and commenting on it. So here we go. Okay, so first spell. Pretty straightforward, just stay under the boss and you'll be fine. And the boss indicator is at the bottom, so you can see where she is. Just stay somewhere in that vicinity, should be fine. Okay, second spell. This is easier than it looks. The green snakes don't really have much of a threat because the lanes are so wide. You probably want to be paying attention more to the purple bullets. Pretty straightforward. Alright, so this is a harder version of the previous spell. So this one, the snakes are actually a bigger threat than the purple bullets because the lanes they form are really weird. It's kind of like Pristine Lunacy from Loke, so you have to practice it a few times to see how the lanes form. See that? That right there was a bit weird. Oh yeah, and I've been experimenting with some recording settings for higher quality, so if you see a bit of lag, that's why. Okay, so this is another version of the same spell, but it's actually probably the easiest. The snakes don't really get anywhere near you, and there's not enough purple bullets to really be a threat, so it should be pretty straightforward. Alright, stage 2 boss. This, you just want to follow the boss and kill her before she fires too much. That's basically it. It's a lot easier if you have homing, of course. See, it gets kind of weird towards the end, but if you kill fast enough, should be fine. This is a harder version of the previous spell, though I don't know if it's actually harder. Seems pretty straightforward because the bullets move very slowly. So for this, she fires aim stuff at you that will block the lane you're in, so you need to misdirect it or circle around her with the gaps in the purple. This spell, you just want to circle around her. Be careful of the jelly beans while you're doing so. The familiar doesn't actually have a hitbox, but you have to be careful of the stuff it spawns. And of course this dies like way faster if you have a homing shot, but even as a non-homing shot, you should be able to finish it in 3 or 4 circles. Alright, stage 3 boss. This one, just follow her around to deal damage. The gaps to dodge are pretty big, so you should have no problem. Okay, For that, you want to go to the side for the explosions. I kind of just got lucky there that I didn't get hit. Just dodge on the side and then get back to do damage. This is just a harder version of the previous spell. I kind of got lucky there. I think I was going for a speed kill there. Okay, so this, be mindful of the big orbs. The hitbox is pretty forgiving, but because there's no borders on the sprite, if there's a lot of them like all bunched up together, you really can't tell where the individual bullets are. So be careful about that. So this is the same spell, but for more spam. So the same thing applies here. Just be mindful of when the big orbs bunch up. Light right there. Almost died there. Okay, saves for you, boss. So she goes around the screen. The first and third positions are static, and then the second position aims at you. I think this is similar to how one of the spells in Toho works, but I don't remember. Just stay in the middle, like right, like what I'm doing right now. It should be fine. So for this spell, you really have to dodge at the sides. And see that wall that I just dodged on the left? It's kind of guiding you to go towards the sides and not stay in the middle. And unfortunately, that makes this last way longer than it should, than if you had homing. But being on the side is a safe strat. Should be pretty simple. Basically Raikou's spell from DDC, but I think it's pretty straightforward. Dodge the arrowheads and then be mindful of the aim blue. Okay, so this one's pretty annoying. You really want the laser, the green lasers, to aim in the top half of the screen, just so it's you don't have to dodge stuff from behind. So I kind of get into this U-streaming pattern where you U-stream the pause, and then you misdirect the green lasers up. And yet again, this is an anti-forward focus spell, because it takes twice as long as it does with homing. The screen shake can also be a little annoying, as you can see there. Okay, so this is the final for this stage 3 boss. You want to lead the cats into a circle, basically. And it should be pretty straightforward, actually, after you get outside the ring and start going in a circle. Alright, stage 4 boss. This spell is really laggy for some reason, so it's actually like easier because of that. The Mentos are aimed and then dodge the purple spam otherwise. It's pretty straightforward because the gaps are pretty big. Just make sure you don't wall yourself by misdirecting one of the Mentos waves into it. But even then, it should be okay. Okay, this spell is the same as the previous spell, but the purple comes from behind. So you have to proactively go down the purple waves while taking care to avoid the Mentos. So this spell's pretty simple because the green goes in straight lines, so just stay at one height and dodge horizontally. Okay, so now we have the harder version of the previous spell. So the green is now wavy. You have to be mindful of that. I don't know what I was doing up here. I should just dodge at the bottom, which I do eventually. And this spell is way easier as homing because the familiars get killed by your homie, so those purple orbs never spawn. But otherwise, you just need to notice them and go around them. This is pretty easy. It's just aim green stuff, so you can just left, right, or stream it, while also dodging some of the random yellow stuff. Pretty straightforward. So I do some speed killing with Diana up here at the beginning. So the green stuff is aimed with red and yellow random-ish stuff. It's pretty straightforward, I think. Just have to be sure you're proactively streaming the green stuff and don't let it surprise you. So this spell, it's basically a test of how well you understand this game's hitboxes. So the hitboxes here are like quite forgiving, so you can get away with some pretty impossible looking dodges. Right there. Okay. This is supposed to be a harder version of the previous spell, but I can't really tell the difference. There's a recolor bullet and the Mentos are retextured. Otherwise, it seems kind of the same. Same idea. Stage 6 mid-boss spell. So it starts aimed around you, gets random, and then turns into a kind of Ringo from Wolke pattern. You just have to learn the lane and get through it. stage 6 spell, stage 6 boss. For this, the lasers will never hit you, they're aimed around you. So just stay high, don't move too much, and then it should just work itself out. You just need to dodge the red stuff, which also despawns after a while, so it's easier than it seems. Alright, so we have the harder version of the previous spell. The lasers are still aimed around you, so don't make large movements. From here, the purple stuff comes from behind, so you have to dodge that. Otherwise, it's the same in concept as the previous spell. So this is just a visual distraction. You want to stay near the boss, so you don't get hit by the things on the side, and then dodge inside the lane. These bullets have more forgiving hitboxes than you might think, so you just need to be careful and stay near the boss and dodge the lanes, and it should be okay. So the harder version of the spell, so now there's two aim sequences of bullets, so you have to dodge basically two streams at once. Basically the same thing, but don't be afraid of going, like, the lanes are kind of less clear here, but don't be afraid to make a dodge between what seems like two bullets that are tied together, because the hitboxes are more forgiving than you might think. So we have the TLB. So the arrowheads aim at you after they hit the wall, so just stay under the boss and then dodge the arrowhead that comes from above, and it should be fine. Alright, the harder version of the previous spell. Don't do what I do here. I was trying some random strat where I'd leave the arrowhead around. What you really want to do is have the arrowhead form a tight circle around you, which I do on this way. You just tap once and then the arrowhead starts circling you, and then you just dodge the white bullets inside the circle. This actually takes a bit longer as homing because your homing shot goes after the familiars, but either way it shouldn't be too bad. Also, one thing to note is the familiars in this game don't have hitboxes. I think most enemies in this game don't have hitboxes, so you don't need to worry about dodging them. Alright, so this laser spell, the lasers are aimed around you. And then there's mildly aimed spam after that, so you just kind of do a kind of streaming pattern. But you don't want to move too violently after the laser spawn, or else you might run into one. Alright, harder version of the previous spell. Same concept. The blue stuff is aimed at you, and the lasers are aimed around you, so you want to be still when the lasers spawn. See, I almost died there because I moved after the lasers spawn. So the stage 6 survival. This is the easier version, but I actually had more trouble capturing this one than the harder version. So in this version, the circle stays in the middle. So the first 40 seconds of the spell is just sitting here and waiting for it to get to the final phase. These rings are of blue, are actually mildly aimed at you. So you can just sit still and then shift over. The final phase, I find it hard to read because the glow effect gets really bad, and then the bullets are very small, so it's harder to read. So I found a strat where I just start here and then shift left until it ends. Alright, so the harder version of the spell, the circle now moves around, which definitely makes the first 40 seconds of the spell a bit more engaging. So it circles twice and then it goes back to the middle for the final phase. So I don't know how much more engaging this is than the original. Okay, and the final phase for this is kind of the same as the previous one, but it's a different sort of bullet, and the pattern is different. I find this pattern actually easier to read, because you sort of dodge two waves at once. But maybe that's just a me thing. Alright, so we have the Stage 6 final. So these blue rings are aimed, and these familiars come from the sides, but you shouldn't let them spook you because they have really low HP, so they should never be able to fire on you before you kill them. If you have homing, this gets really easy. Well, it's already easy, but you kill all the familiars before they can even reach you. Starting with phase 2, there's these gold bullets, which is basically streaming. Just get in the gap, tap a few times, and then get in the next gap. And you don't even have to worry about the familiars here. Just focus on the yellow bullets. And for the final phase, it's the same thing, but the gaps get smaller because of the blue bullets. Especially when you're restreaming or getting to a new gap, just be careful. Don't go too far. Yeah, this should end. Alright, so we have the extra mid-boss spells. This one's just random spam. It's pretty easy, I think. Basically, the only threatening thing is the green spam, which there isn't a lot of. Each character has their own two extra mid-boss spells. So this is the second one. This one's actually kind of tricky. It's really fast. What I find helpful is not to move too much. Just kind of narrow your field of vision, and it should be fine. Alright, so this is Diana's two mid-boss spells. This one's just aimed green stuff and then white scattered stuff. It's pretty easy. Actually, it's really easy. Just follow her around and deal damage. Alright, so this is technically Diana's. Only Diana sees this, but this spell is pretty hard to do with no power. As a forward focus shot. I tried several times and I just timed it out instead, so I'm using the homing shot instead. It's safer on the sides, usually. Kind of alternates between where the save points are. I don't know how else to describe it, just play it a few times, you'll see. This is Angelica's mid-boss spell. You're supposed to just circle it, which was kind of boring. It's trivial. So I do a kind of speed kill here with Diana instead, just to show it off. This is Diana's other mid-boss, extra mid-boss spell. You just get in the middle and spin around a few times. And then it'll force you outside. And then just go outside and it should end pretty quickly. So it should die within one wave. Or even less if you have more power. Alright, so this is extra boss's spells. These are aim. Just know how wide the spam will be. It should be fine once you learn how big or how wide the spam is. Alright, I think this is inspired by Starboard Break from UST. It's just random spam. Just dodge. It's not very difficult spam, so it should be doable. This one, I would focus mainly on the silver and gold bullets from the side. The green is very regular, so it's pretty easy to get used to it. So I would focus on dodging the stuff from the side. And that will naturally mostly get you through the aim large bullets as well. Because those are really slow in their aim. So as long as you're moving, those shouldn't hit you. This seems very arcadey. I think it's inspired by something, but I don't know what. Just stay in the lane, stay under her, and deal damage. Sometimes it'll force you to do a micro if there's no room in the lane and she moves while she's firing. But it should be okay. The gaps are forgiving. This is kind of like Koshi's spell. You want to move in an end pattern, or like a crisscross pattern, infinity symbol pattern. You want to lead her to the top of the screen so you can deal damage while she's coming down. And of course, it's way easier if you have homing. But just repeat the process several ways until it dies. Yeah, don't get greedy and try to finish it quickly. Just play it safe. It should be fine. This is pretty easy for being late in an extra fight. Basically, it's just two waves of silver bullets. Yeah, it's the stuff in the on the sides of the screen is not even a threat. And it has pretty low HP, so should be straightforward. Alright, this spell is Shinmyomaru's laser non, but faster and more random. So it can randomly meme you. So just pray for good RNG or have fast reflexes. See, right here I just get in between two lanes, just due to luck. This spell is static, but I didn't actually learn a strat. I just kind of dodged randomly until I captured it, so Sorry, I can't really provide the strat here. But it is static, so if you find something that works, you can try to replicate it. And the hitboxes are pretty forgiving. So the extra survival. So it starts with this just random spam, just dodge it. And then it has this aim stuff. You want to move in a square pattern or a rectangle pattern. And then now two or more start appearing. You just want to misdirect them as usual. I kind of get off a route and miraculously survive, so don't follow what I do here. Next we have the extra final. It's a pretty straightforward, just raw dodging spell. It's kind of like Saki's final from Toe 17. Though I think it's easier than that spell. I think it's just because the crisscross bullets move so slowly, you can read them way ahead in advance. And then the final, or this phase, you just get stuff on the sides of the lane, which isn't really much of a threat. Final phase, you get more of the downward aim stuff, but it's also not too bad. Alright, next we have overdrives from each character, stuff that's not usually in game. So this is a stage 1 boss's overdrive. It's very, very weird how the helixes spawn, and then the blue stuff is aimed afterward. If you have homie, you can kill the familiars that spawn the helixes, which will make it slightly easier. If you don't, well, good luck. I just kind of rely on my homie to deal extra damage here. Stage 2 bosses, overdrive. This one's pretty cool. So basically, she fires these aimed jelly beans at you, while the bullets on the outside form this rotating ring. It's like the biohazard symbol, something like that, which slowly forms these cells, and you have to basically switch between the cells while avoiding the pink jelly beans, like so. It can get a bit of a tight squeeze, especially this last wave, but it should be fine. It might be harder if you're not homing. Alright, stage 3. This is the same as her final, but with aim blue stuff and also aim stars. Kind of works the same way, just stream to avoid the aim stuff and then watch out for walls from the big bullets. There's less vines, less of the gold and green vines in this spell, so that's less of a threat here. This one, oh, that was
barely avoided the death there from a wall of golden bullets. Stage 4. The Poros can wall you, because they get denser every wave. And then the golden large orbs, it's more Ringo style, going through the lanes and knowing when to go reverse through the lanes when you have to. It's pretty challenging, especially when the Poros are not nice. And then the orange stuff is always aimed around you, so as long as you don't move too fast, it should be fine. But it's this one's definitely pretty challenging. Okay. This is a stage 5 overdrive. So you circle once, a full circle, around. And then it just becomes a left-right streaming spell. So there's a gap, get into the gap, and then just go to the right, get to the gap, go to the left, get in the gap, go to the right, and then repeat until it's over. It probably lasts a couple more waves if you're not homing, but the dodging is pretty simple. Once you find the gap, it might be a little hard to see at first. This is a stage 5 mid spell as a spell now. Gets gradually denser, and then the blue stuff is aimed at you. I would try to stay still while the blue stuff is spawning, just so you don't have to dodge that far. And then focus on dodging the white bullets. Alright, stage 6 overdrive. So this is aimed at you. Just tap to dodge. And then she adds these blue bolts. Just watch, be on the lookout while you're tapping to dodge the red. And then she adds these things from above, so you can't see at the bottom anymore. It's just another set of bolts you have to watch out for while you're tapping. It's pretty easy. It's much easier than the other overdrives, actually. It's just aim stuff. Bit of random spam, and then some loosely aimed spam. But it's not even threatening, even the later phases. I think the later phases, it doesn't make anything denser, it just makes the waves come faster. Alright, so now each player character has their own overdrive based on their bomb, I think. So I clear them with themselves. This is just spam bats with aim glow bullets. It's pretty easy. All the player character overdrives are pretty easy. Just somewhat of a shame. But... later phases, just more aimed stuff, which you can just stream the same as before. Alright, Diana's overdrive. You basically just stay near her, and that's it. If you stay away from the bombs, there's basically nothing that's a threat, except the purple butterflies, which are very sparse. All I don't even know what's different about the second phase, but in the final phase she starts firing these rings. So you have to, you can't stay as close to her, but even then it's still pretty easy. Alright, finally we have Angelica's overdrive. So the first phase is just left, right, left, right. These hitboxes are very forgiving, so you don't really even have to be that precise. This isn't Junko. This next phase is more left-right. Once you settle into a rhythm, it's pretty easy. The final phase is a bit challenging though. It's also left-right, but the speed of the rice bullets can be a bit hard to read. So just dodge. Alright, so that's it. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.